That's a new game for all the people watching.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Training Mode Network. If you are unfamiliar, we are... Did you just burp?
No.
I hate you.
Duff doesn't know about my secret mating call. Let's go.
I hate you.
Wait, what?
Your mating call? Who are you trying to bait with in the call right now? Okay, anyway, if you're unfamiliar with TMN, we are a beginner and intermediate fighting game community. We run tournaments nearly every night of the week and community events on Saturdays. Speaking of community events, we got the Honest Fundamentals versus Anime Bullshit team battle in Super Street Fighter 2 Turbo tomorrow. Here is the sign-up link for that. We need more for Honest Fundamentals, which I know is not something I should be pleading for on the Guilty Gear Plus R tournament, but we do need that. That being said, this is going to happen tomorrow at Saturday 9:30. Saturday September 30th at 12 p.m. PST, 2 p.m. CST, 3 p.m. EST here on my Twitch. yeah, he's in the lobby. That being said, I do have something else I am going to reveal today, so I will go ahead and do that right now. Well, welcome everyone to the new era of Blitz War. Blitz War, if you didn't know, has recently rebranded to the Training Mode Network. And we are now running other games besides Exard. So we're running a BBCF bracket tonight. The power's yet unknown.
When I'm a I could get a high to collect. Select, show me your best. That crystal blister, it's all over now. Psychic game, music, you need more than anything. Okay, COVID freaks, got a high kick, missed with twister, moist with worsening. Stick it up, check it up, step a set, a cigar will affect. So back, take a bow to the moon.
It's gonna need one more after this.
What?
Hey. Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god!
Morning rays, hairspray keys, get on the way to the next, the west on it. They once had a dream, spells of society, shells of immunity. Cornet and spinach, sound flows, falls to the home, dragged by the power of dream. That power's yet unknown. Morning rays, hands straight to the end of the way to the nest, the west, the honest. They once had a dream, fell with society, the shell of unity. Cornet and spinet, the sound flows. Falls to the home, dragged by the power of a dream. That power is yet unknown. That power is yet unknown. That power is yet unknown. That power is yet unknown.
Okay, well, if you saw that, thanks for watching. I made that myself. I hope you all liked it. That is the reveal for our anniversary event in December 7th. Will be the first year anniversary of TMN. Not the first year anniversary of, like, the group, because we were under the name Blitz War. We ran Guilty Gear, Exard, Beginner and Intermediate tournaments for the Southern U.S. back on Delay Base. So it's not a year of this community, but it is a year of the Training Mode Network. So the final exam is a tournament, is a all-day event on December 2nd here on my channel, where the graduates of TMN, of all our games, are tasked, if they want to get their diploma, in heavy air quotes, are tasked with running a tournament all by themselves. So that should be really fun. I hope y'all all show up for that. Graduates, we have two people in the bracket who can graduate tonight. We have Blood Falcon, aka Luke, Devil Luke, some of you may know him as, and we have Jacob, who doesn't have an AKA. So those two can graduate tonight. Other than that, we've got 32 people in the tournament tonight. I don't know how, but we did. So congrats, everyone. Thanks for coming out. This is our biggest plus R bracket ever. So I'm joined on commentary today by King Nothing and T5, the Dream Team. Go ahead.
Ah, yes. Me and my buddy Luigi here are here to... Oh, what an air throw!
I hate... T5. Oh my god. Okay. Anyway.
This is
one of the most fun... Like, this is one of the most interesting matchups that there is. In general, in terms of, like, soul matchups. Because of the way that Axel both controls neutral and Oki, and yet so can Soul. It's very range dependent, right? Whenever either Jaker gets into, like, their preferred range, the other one has a hard time, but then that battle to get into that range is just beautiful.
Yeah, it's kind of like...
Ooh, what you doing, bro?
It's like nice. Two kids at the grocery store in a fight. Like, you never know which one's gonna beat the other one up. It's like the best way I can describe it. And by that,
don't
I mean, like...
Mind.
Soul Bad Guy can, like, slip through a lot of Axel's stuff. But if Axel's playing on point, he can react and stuff Soul. But it gets really nebulous, because if Axel's off by a little bit, Soul gets in, and Soul has a lot of great ways of just disrupting Axel's defensive options.
Again, that's true until you factor in 3P. Axel 3P is just a monster of a button. In every single matchup, but in this one in particular, it really helps you control that mid-range in a very commanding way. Anyway, here we see some Oki. Nice, good wall throw. One... Two.
Ow.
Wait, nice. Okay, gets the counter hit. A decent anti jump out option. Nice. Okugeki. Nice. Alright, 2H and Oki.
Punch right in the kneecap, and that'll do it.
Yeah, you can't go for those cheeky resets against Soul because he's trying to.
Oh, there it is. One misplaced 5P. Sorry about your accident.
Those were five.
What? Is that a knowledge check, or is that just like...
I
Colonel of Beyond should sign up for that ST battle tomorrow. They're already ready to play. They got their old Ken on deck right now.
Nice.
Nice FRC.
Nice. Mm-hmm. Fucking punish, baby. Okay, that's fine.
Nice. Honestly, even just taking the positions, okay. Ooh, what the fuck? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, whoa.
Okay. Nice, relax. Always got an FD when you're ready to attack. Okay. FD, good.
Oh.
Only minus 6, you gotta be careful of that.
Yeah, it's really weird to punish. Usually, it's one of the best moves to practice, like, slashbacking, though, because of how long you have to, like, see it happen, and you can slashback the last hit of FB Fafnir, and as scary as it sounds...
Yeah, Vulture can no longer be the pride of North Carolina, it is now Cheerio.
Yeah, but let's see if Lurking can, like, adapt, you know, and... Nice, okay, almost got a good punish. You can 6P that, remember. Nice. Yeah. Nice. Oh, beautiful. Beautiful. Koku. Nice. Honestly, Lurking could probably afford to, like, not. Like, you know, just take that space that he gets after Koku Retro and not force the issue. Further, but. And Lurking. Oh, big drop.
Ah!
No. Come on, Lurking. Okay, but you wasted your burst. There we go. Okay.
I'm shocked that JS whiffed.
Yeah. But Lurking is a round up, so even if Turtle gets this, and if Lurking gets his burst back, then everything is good. 0-1-1. There we go. Ah, you gotta air throw that. Ooh, okay, drops. Nice. Burst.
Good blocks.
Nice, just relax. Ooh, beautiful. Ooh. Nice, good Benton.
Yeah. I think that's it.
Oh,
Guts! It's a scary position.
Nice,
yes,
Benton.
Oh no, whoa. You gotta space those out.
Yeah, you gotta be further. It's scary because he thinks like, oh, I'm not gonna get any pressure. But again, in this match, if you're not looking for pressure, nice, beautiful. Also, look at this. Lurking has his burst with Turtle Gun. He's very good. Nice. Okay. Nice, beautiful. No! It's a big drop. Benton? Ah. Yo! Oh. No meter, come on. Big punish.
That was really unfortunate.
Yeah.
I have to use the restroom, but I will be right back.
Wow. My number one recommendation for working. You gotta control like a specific spacing, and you don't need to be like in really like half that advantage in the match, you know? Because again, I get it, right? This is like, oh, it's plus R, you know? Oh, you gotta be in. I get it, but you know, the whole thing about Axel is like mid-range specialist, and this is something that is really accented when you're playing against Soul. Where it's like the number one thing you want to do is control that mid-range and just not let him throw bullshit or throw much at you, right? Obviously still has ways to move around stuff. These are things that you have like more immediate counters to than most people do to like, I don't know, Soul, run up 2D, run up 2S, or Riot Stamp, Grand Viper, whatever. Yeah. Honestly, at a lot of points you were winning, right? It then just like something unfortunate happened or like a small mistake happened. But honestly, you had this tag.
Up next, we are going to have Gorlami's Salami. He took it over our second place last week, Circuit Sturgeon. So, and we're going to have Double Bear.
Nice.
Another North Carolina player. I don't know who Gorlami's Salami plays, but we'll figure it out.
Me neither. Yeah. And after this match, we're going to have Chicken Alfredo. Is that what I heard?
Yeah, my husband's making Chicken Alfredo, so it's...
I believe Gorlami Salami plays Pot, which is going to be pretty interesting because in a similar way to like where Axel versus Soul is a bit of a unquote knowledge checking matchup in the sense that it really tests like how strong you are controlling spacing, Hot versus Johnny is also very much a knowledge check match in terms of like how good are your misfinder cancels and how good are you at staying safe after, you know, at once you're in, right? Because a lot of the time, right, like Pod can just like hammer fall through stuff, and like if you're not clean and on point, you're gonna get shit on. So it's important to always be on point. We're gonna see how this goes. See, I mean, round start, a decent option is just like 5k and then just get out, and then you can like buffer a close slash or whatever, like a far slash. Nice. Okay. Okay. Burn out a few coins. Nice. Nice. There we go. Gets a coin. Nice. Oh, beautiful. Yo. Ah. Almost. Nice, there we go. Oh, the ground killers, let's go. Oh no. Oh, these two ages. I wonder if Double Bear is like an exert player. Blech. Nice. Ah, you gotta throw us. Always throw us. Nice. Ooh, Ensenga, nice. Nice, good coins. There we go, catch his ass. Oh! Almost. Come on. Alright, there we go. Biggest? No. Biggest meter. Ah! Ooh! Burst out. Come on. Good! Ah, beautiful. Beautiful, 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 beautiful stuff. Here we go. Nose. Nice. Nice. Coin.
I'm back. Excuse me.
Okay. There we go. It's the back dash.
Alright, so this is Pot Johnny, huh?
Yeah, I mentioned before that it's like kind of knowledge checking in a similar way to like Soul versus Axel in the sense that like it tests how clean you can play.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Nice, good TK and Senga. Nice. There we go, burst. Gorlami could afford to represent Hammerfall a bit more since Johnny kinda struggles to deal with it. Or it doesn't necessarily struggle, but it's kind of. There we go, nice. Oh.
Nice. Yeah, it's just really, really clean. As Johnny, your main goal is to kind of stay at the mid range and just kind of reactively poke and box Pot into the corner and just kill away at his life.
Yeah, if you look at Suzume playing this matchup, or even small, like more specifically Sato, it's literally neutral jump JS, neutral jump JS, mm-hmm. neutral jump JS, neutral jump JS, 5k, neutral jump JS. And if you get a hit, you just hit him from into Ensenga, and then you forget about it. Nice. Punish? Oh, almost. Oh.
Oh dear. Ooh. Nice. Ah. He's out.
The hammerfall break. Okay, there we go.
Ooh.
That is the most fake as fuck, but real as fuck.
Yeah, you know.
Bro I've ever seen. Alright, Gorlami getting some early lead in the first round. Nice. Nice. Frankly, another thing about the matchup is that, like, as Pot, you have more room to abuse and punching stuff. And just in general, like, abuse the fact that, you know, Johnny's tall and doesn't have many defensive options. You have more chances to, like, abuse that than most characters do.
Yep.
Right. Oh, beautiful! Oh, that was sick. Oh my god. Wait. Double Bear might be the goat. Hold on. Oh!
Honestly, what's great, too, about, like, Pot air-teching out in those situations is that you're just way less scared as Johnny. Because Pot's air options are, like, what, another jump and that's a...
Yeah. Nice. Oh, beautiful. Beautiful. Alright, let's see if Gorlami, Salami can bring it back and, you know, some stuff with it. Nice.
That's really straightforward, clean pressure. Nice up coin. Oh, that medium too!
Bop! There we go. Yo, ooh, I thought it, oh my god. I thought we were doing like...
Barret's kinda cooking right now.
Yeah.
Look at this, sitting right at perfect mid-range, yep. Big chillin', yep.
Nice.
Yep.
Oh my god!
Okay, don't gotta worry about it.
Hold on. This is different. This is a little different. Barret's kinda cooking, hold on. This is crazy. I'm gonna shoot to both players. But wow, Double Barret playing really impressively.
Yeah.
In one moment. Ugh.
Okay, awesome. Well, Double Barret will move on to fight Vegan on stream. Let's fucking go. That's so funny. Oh,
that's Let's exciting.
We gotta start.
Update on the rest of the bracket. We got Espada over Offensive, gonna be on stream next round. Chart over Busy Casual. And Luke over Turtle and Beyond. Tanzip and Mikey are still playing Winner Gets Luke. Jacob and Akai are still playing Winner Gets Chart. And Pada and TJ are about to play on stream. So I was told Portland locals were canceled. So TJ can play tonight, and I'm really excited to see her.
Ooh.
So this will be Soul versus Abba, which we've seen a ton of times, but we've never seen this Soul versus Abba. TJ is like such an interesting player to me, and I'm really excited to see how she does tonight.
Definitely a wild card. She plays pretty well.
She's a good player, and she one of my favorite things about her is I think she thinks about the game really well in a really interesting and good way. Healthy way too.
100%. Here we go. So this matchup, to me, kind of plays out in two phases. And that's Soul dealing with normal mode Abba, and then Soul dealing with other modes. And we're about to see the second phase immediately. That guard bar is looking delightful right now. Oh no! Okay. Nice DP. Oh my, TJ is going in right now. Oh dear. Burst does not want to get hit by this combo. Oh no, 5k is not going to do it there. Oh no. Wait, oh no, Pada! Pada with the drop.
Keep It the Gates is such a good song. I fuck heavily with this song. Espada's in tonight. Yeah, Espada's in tonight. Oh, Espada, you said no Espada in the chat, and I was like, yeah, he's here. My man would never miss a plus R TMN. Oh no, whiffs the Grand Viper into the Morha. Misses the conversion there. DPs the knockdown, oh no. Looking pretty rough for Potter right now, but she is in more. He is in Morha, so oh, he FRC'd that. Nice. Gonna get this knockdown. Burst on deck for TJ, but I can't imagine she uses it this round. Both players with not a lot of meter. Gonna DP? No DP. Oh, gets hit by the overhead. Into death. Pada bringing that round back.
Yeah, that was. Oof. That being said, TJ is entering this round. She's in a really good position because, you know, she's got burst, she's got... You know, having burst over Abba, really.
It's really powerful, yeah. It's definitely something when you lose it... Oh my god, the damage!
Oh.
She's got these! That was sick, TJ!
Well, this is really good for TJ because, yeah. Like, even if Pata installs now, the gameplay has to be, like, perfectly- oh, that was so sick! Nice!
Oh my god, she's so sick.
The gameplay has to be good. Like, when you chip away so much of Abba's health before she's installed, it means that when she goes into Marha mode and starts spending health, even when she regenerates it in Goku mode and uses Blood Pack, she's not in, like, a super great position. Because it might look like Abba's, like, nearly dead when she's installed and doing big combos, and then she's about to, you know, flip back to normal mode. But depending on how the round has been going, it can be a very different story, and she might just heal a ton of health. But when you've chipped away so much against normal mode Abba and she can't burst to get out, or, like, get a free blood pack or whatever, it's... The tempo really changes, and it means Abba has to be correct more.
Yeah, I think Abba is really mostly about mitigating risk against her and shutting down any of her options. Like, it's not about just, like,
depleting
her health bar to
zero. Right?
You don't want her to ever be able to get away with anything. You don't want to let her play the game because she will beat you.
Not for free, at least. You want to make sure that you're taxing her resources.
Yeah, that's definitely something that I think is important. Against snowball-heavy resource characters who have to manage their resource to get their game plans.
Nice! Pick up! Ah! Nice. Okay, you know what? You really want to take the knockdown here. Okay. I guess Pato just didn't take. It's fine. You get a knockdown. Just like Oprah, when you get cars. Oh no! Oh no, knockdown! Speaking of no knockdown, okay, yeah, you got a burst.
Yeah, that was a bursting starter. Okay, you gotta be really careful here.
Yeah, this is a tough situation. Oh, Pod doesn't want to give up the round!
Epi slide. Move past that situation. Oh, nice! Low profile with the 5k! I see a DP coming from TJ soon. Find a gap. Oh, nice!
Yeah, big thing for Soul in this matchup is that is that 5k is a pretty solid anti-air against normal mode Abba. Anyways, yeah, 5k is like it'll do work against normal mode Abba trying to jump in carelessly, but against Moroha you really really gotta have anti-air VV. Like, it is, you're not beating JH in the 5k.
Yeah,
that's just not
JH
happening.
Is just kind
it's
of
probably
a
possible in some range situations. Oh wow, what a key grab! Oh no punish from Pata. That's huge. That was like the perfect ground viper burst, but like, oh my god, never mind. I guess it really depends, but it's not. See, there we go. That's usually what happens. Alright, yeah, Pata has to be really careful here. Yeah, even so, right? This is like. Yep. That's just one of those situations where, like, if you've chipped away so much of Abba's health before she's started to get going, when she has to make those exits, it's gonna be really bad if she gets hit again. Oh, hey, I see Panda Vedic in the chat.
Yeah.
Shoutouts to my guy. My favorite panda medic, Panda Vedic. He does not actually work at an animal hospital, but if he could be a panda medic, I think he would be. What's up? Not much. I'm hanging out, enjoying this awesome beginner bracket. I'm not gonna lie to you. I kinda want to see Double Bear versus Vegan before anything else.
We're gonna get Luke and Tanzip up because Vegan has to delay his a little bit.
You're eating? Oh, I get it because of your name! Very good joke, but I mean,
so
like,
true.
Pop up.
Tanzip took it over Mikey 2-0. Was supposed to play Stereo Sounds round one, but Stereo Sounds didn't show up.
Oh, Dizzy Justice. Okay, this is
tough. Oh my god, the mother-daughter battle.
This is somewhat challenging if Justice can't get started really fast and hold momentum. Because Justice sending Dizzy full screen is not particularly a problem for Dizzy, who will gladly just do that. Oh, but this is the problem. If Justice gets in on Dizzy and starts running mix, that is when things can get dangerous.
Yeah, and Justice has a big body, so it's pretty easy to mix her with some stuff Dizzy can't do on other characters, right?
Oh, that Justice can't really do much about Dizzy summoning from afar outside of like spending a lot of meter. And even then, depending on how late your reaction is, you might just hit the
back dash with the sickle.
Nope. Like, oh, and of course, yeah, you mentioned Justice is huge, so Justice will get hit by all sorts of messed up, awful things, which
yeah,
is also
and
true.
Also, I feel like, you know, one of the big things for Dizzy is, like, if she gets that knockdown in the corner with Microdash K-Fish, and then wants to do IADJS at the lowest possible height, it's hard. It's really hard. You have to get, like, an almost near-frame perfect air dash to do it, and on larger characters, you can do it much easier.
Yep. And again, like, look at, like, the way to mitigate what Dizzy is doing is just very hard for Justice.
Yeah, Justice has amazing buttons, but yeah. Oh, nice!
Yeah, Justice's buttons are amazing on the condition that you have to, like, move towards her.
Yeah, and she does not have great ways to move towards you that aren't committal in any way.
Yeah, Superior, and, like, you're just spending a ton of meter to hope to God Dizzy doesn't block it and kill you. Like, oh my god, that was Luke just saying, I'm gonna give you that round. You gotta be really careful bursting that high. But yeah, big thing too, right, is that usually Dizzy neutral is punctuated by she needs fish out because characters can either move around or swing somewhat large buttons that can contest hers because of her hurt boxes and everything. But again, since Justice movement is very, very linear and not particularly great, like, the ways Justice has to discourage Dizzy are pretty limited.
What the fuck? Who won that game? Tanza?
No, that was Luke.
Where the fuck did Kayn go?
Kayn
nothing?
Hey, do you want me to add Draco Dragon really quick?
No, he said he couldn't commentate. He's taking a break from fighting games right now, so whatever.
Wait, Draco Dragon 42?
Yeah, he told me that last time. He said he had fun commentating, but he probably wouldn't be able to commentate another one anytime soon. His schedule is getting busy.
Oh.
Yeah, due to college. On that note, hi.
Hi. A wizard always appears when he's needed.
Yeah, no, that's what I'm saying. Especially this wizard.
yep, that's what happens! You can't even do that! The fact that move hits full screen is actually so bad, because it means even if the fish is, like, way behind Dizzy and not anywhere near you, you're gonna just hit the fish.
Yep,
priority. And Dizzy's gonna go, ha-ha! Walk two squares, get $500.
Pretty much.
Monopoly.
Ice, good ice spike.
No, Peter, it's really different. You have to understand, I say that about Cliff Dizzy because that's like a probability. Like, it's so much harder for Justice to get that hit here.
Nice, beautiful throw. Yes, I'm to jump mid. Nice.
Oh,
I mean, the green bar, the
Luke,
green bar.
Luke was like, oh, wait. Right, I don't have to go in or, like, guess. I can just run good, safe pressure.
Yep.
What is Dizzy gonna, or what is Justice gonna do if I am, like, at max range and I do FB Needle? Jump? Like, it's tough for sure. Like I said, Justice can definitely, like, kill the hell out of that character if Justice can get Dizzy knocked down in the corner. That is, like, the situation. It's not just anywhere on the screen, it is quite literally in the corner. hey, Foxplush, if you want to take my spot and give it a try, I will actually gladly allow you to give it a shot if you'd like. Who cares? Well, I mean, the survey people might, but not me. I'm different.
Yeah.
Go ahead, just hop
in. Survey will never take us down, T5, you and me. Alright, ooh, yeah, this is gonna be interesting. Jacob, the hero of the 2v2, and Chart Soul.
British the hero of the United Kingdom.
Yes.
Would I call him British Batman?
Yeah.
I don't remember why that became a meme.
This is a pretty fun matchup. Soul 5H is a haymaker, which stops Kai from getting into his, like, comfortable ranges. On the flip side, though, the fact that Kai can actually do stuff outside of those ranges, whereas Soul kind of struggles to, is pretty important.
Yeah, it's pretty interesting. I think this matchup really comes down to, like, Kai's distance presence versus Soul's up-close presence, and how good Kai is at boxing Soul out of it. And vice versa, right? Like, Central. Kai doesn't want to be next to Soul unless he's at, like, frame advantage. And Soul doesn't want to be far away from Kai unless he's knocked Kai down and is running up to do a meeting. So, like, right. It's a really interesting push and pull dynamic.
Nice.
Like, a lot of people think about, like, Ryu versus Ken, but it's like that if the differences were so dialed.
Yeah, exactly.
Nice, RC to stay in. Oh, Jacob's like, I don't want to give it up. That actually might be crucial.
Oh my god, the hero versus the hero.
Also, Kai, despite what you think, probably actually does have pretty good Oki at stopping almost every Soul reversal option, which is helpful.
Yes.
Like, it's not to be overlooked how good Air CSE is, how good FD Star can be on Oki, how good even just JD can be against Soul, depending on how they're playing. Like that? Yeah, look, that shuts down so much. He wanted to air throw that man's burst.
Yeah, and here's the other thing, which is that, like, given how Kai wants to pressure and in general move in the matchup, it's not as though Kai is going to get, like, a bunch of low damage confirms, right? Because a lot of Kai's stop signs in and of themselves are actually lead to, like, pretty decent reward.
Yeah, they're really good starters. Usually it's something like a 2H or a really big air-to-air, and then he can usually turn that into, like, either a good air reset for damage or, like...
Yeah, or even stuff like 5H, Orb, JD, FB Star. There we go. Orb.
Yeah, this is one of those matchups where Kai really gets to swing around those buttons that he doesn't normally get to press with impunity against a lot of other characters.
Right.
And that's a really big deal because those buttons happen to be really good starters. What a freaking throw. Oh no, I think he messed up a meaty. It's okay though. Greed Sever, let's go, baby. Sets up the star, nice block from Chart Soul. Yeah, just getting out. Oh no, wasn't ready.
No. Red Stomp just beats 3H. Okay.
Well, yeah, but nice. I meant more that, like, he recovered.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, nice. Oh, beautiful.
Oh, Lightning Orb, yeah.
The fuck?
Oh, wait. Nice. Is it because it's a projectile? Or did he just duck under the star? I think he might have just ducked under it.
Yeah, no, I think he just ducked under it because I've seen certain costs of doing, like, Sid Sage jump cancel, star FD, and the star even hits Tyrari, so.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Terry versus Charlotte from Samjil. That's a good way of putting it, too.
That's fucked up. Anyway, let's see. Match number two. Wow, immediately going for the air dash gauge. I have to be a little more forcing.
Oh, Kai 6H. Such a nice. Good pressure tool. Ooh, here we go.
Yo,
oh,
the
block! What a block!
We're not getting filtered by Froton Tactics today!
Nice.
I talked to Froton today, he sent me a picture of his monkeys. He told me his D-pad on his controller broke and he can't get another one, so that's why he's been playing nothing but EverQuest 6. Because he's the analog 6 still.
Yeah, big counter hit! I don't know if that was the best damage Jacob could have gotten in that situation, but he's looking to save his meter!
Nice.
Nice, yep.
Oh my god, this, you know what this reminds me of? I don't know if you've ever seen
Ooh!
It. You know the Best Bouts series of exhibition matches? They had like Machibo versus O12.
That was genuine. What was that? Did you see that?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Ooh. High five.
Oh! Can people stop saying Kai isn't cool? You're not a contrarian, you're just wrong.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh no! Okay! You were ready, you were ready, you were ready, you were ready. Alright.
Oh my god. Oh my god, chill. Jacob, relax. Jacob, chill.
Hi Fox Flesh, welcome. Hello, you need to join the room.
Hi. I just pinged you with the role in the TO chat.
Yeah.
The room. Oh, Fox Clutch. Flux Clutch. Flux Clutch. That's what they should call you when you clutch it out.
I'm coming in clutch. Let's go. Let's see.
Yeah.
So we got the Johnny Mirror coming out.
Oh. We're gonna have a Spotter versus DJ first. The West Coast team kill.
Vegan looking kind of like what happens when you crouch in Super Mario, you know, when you duck.
DJ Brown versus a Spotter.
I thought we had Vegan versus Double Bear now. Are they gonna have Spotter?
No, Dove is like holding me hostage here. He's like, nah, you wanna
I'm
see
giving
that?
Vegan time
too bad.
To eat!
To be fair, right? Dove loves holding people hostage.
Yeah, Dove is a known war criminal.
Yeah.
I do.
Okay, thanks.
What people don't know is that the reason why I'm always late to these brackets is because, like, Dove takes away my glasses and I can't get out of the basement.
Oh!
Like that guy that was chained up in the cave in that one myth, and, like, he was like, holy shit, I don't even know what the real world would look like anymore. That's like me after commentating TMN brackets.
Yeah, I only know plus R, that's all.
Ooh, big fixation block!
Anti-air sweep!
Nice!
The block theory.
Nice pressure? Oh no, FRC on the gun plane.
No!
Drop the grand viper.
If that connected, I would have shit my pants. Nice. Done. There we
go. Combo.
Mage. Okay.
That was a good block.
Viper looks button. Like a strong button in this matchup, but Mei looks like she's also got some pretty big sweeps to counter.
Yeah, so 5k on Soul, right? It's like a timing minigame, and it really depends on what button Mei is pressing on the way down. Like, it'll snipe out late JH, but J2H is a little dicey.
Yeah, the best practice for this matchup is just run under 5k. Just slightly easier due to the fact that Mei's jump arc isn't shallow, it's actually very up and down. Yeah, very vertical.
I also want to applaud the zoning there. I'm a sucker for zoning, so.
Nice. OJS. Okay. Kind of lofty advantage.
2H was really ambitious. There we go! That was that's exactly it. Perfect example.
There we go. Did you ever hear about Slash Gordon's fucked up OS?
Whoa! Let's go.
Yeah, Slash Gordon has this fucked up OS where it's like, if you hear two steps, it's command grab, but if you hear three steps, then it's just a dash or some shit.
I mean, if it works,
because the animation's a little slower.
Yeah, no, it's literally purely audio. The way that he did the thing.
Popped over.
TJ, she's definitely not about to flashback that in there. Or at all. Because I don't know if
she
knows. A combo.
So this is a really hard situation. Yeah.
Ooh, no.
Whenever you're at a health deficit against Mei and you're a character that doesn't have like really big command over the neutral game, it can feel really frustrating to try and move towards her because it's just like really not in your favor.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Because normally the big weakness of Mei is that she does have to bulldog in usually. So she's sort of hoping that you mess up anti-airing her if she's trying to approach you. But when you gotta go at her, that's when it gets, oh my god.
Nice.
Wow.
Knockdown. Counter.
5H. Oh, I know why that missed too. Because that was a crouching hit. But Mei's head like leans back during her crouching hit animation. So that Bandit Bringer just whiffed, even though that is a crouch confirm on most characters. Oh yeah, anti-air 2D is also not a meme in this matchup at all. It's really good. Really though, the biggest thing Soul has is anti-air VV. Just having like such a good vertical interrupt against standard Mei stuff. Good jump! Nice FD!
Woo!
These run-unders are so clean from TJ right now. Oh!
That's traded.
Nice! 5k! Alright, TJ, fighting for survival here. Nice air throw, here we go. Okay, is that me started?
Jump heavy slash, just not good enough at the moment.
2S Abare, interesting choice.
Ugh.
Oh no! Oh, SBV actually going through the dolphin with the added invincibility. Lots of counter hits. You really gotta be careful!
Yeah.
Oh, TJ, not wanting to give up a single round. This is a, yeah. One of those things about bursts that you gotta remember, right? If you can, if you don't really clearly see, like, a pathway to victory, it's always good to just hold on to it for the next win.
It's too much of a valuable resource to really hand over that easily.
Yep. 100% agreed. Like, the value of a burst in this game is so huge.
Especially against someone like Mei who can just one-shot you and give it to you.
Yes! Characters like Mei, Cliff, Abba, those are the ones you really want to have that for. Because, like, it's gonna happen. You are gonna have a situation where Mei gets, like, the best counter hit ever, and you're gonna want burst. Because otherwise it's... Okay, but operative term is if it works. And I'd rather focus on what works more. But that was well played to both players. TJ was making a lot of really good adaptations. I really think, though, that what ended up costing her was that burst at the end. I think if she had that burst on deck in round two, or round three there, it would have been... It would have given her more opportunities to reverse the momentum and take back control. But we finally made it.
Yeah, it is a common issue I see among a lot of players is the hero burst.
Yes.
Not the team kill. Chart had to kill Mikey.
Or like my favorite other kind of burst is like the oh I'm angry that you hit me burst, which I do sometimes too. It happens. Yeah. Like, emotional bursting is something that I say you can't do. But even I do it sometimes. It's you're never going to be perfect, but it's good to recognize it and be cognizant of it. All right, here we go. Johnny Mirror.
A lot of things coming out from BD early.
They spent 10 seconds not hitting each other.
There we go. First
because it's kind of like, how do you get into Johnny's range, right? Ask Johnny.
As Johnny? Yeah, I don't know.
It's kind of like the Zato matchup. I don't feel like Johnny has good tools to deal with Johnny.
Nice.
I don't know. Vegan, there's some better possible decision. There.
Nice 6P.
Nice. Although I do have to say, you should always be buffering Misfire Cancel behind every single 6P. Because it just makes the conversions literally a million times better. Always.
Oh, they both 6K.
Nice. Gotta get that OTG. Nice.
Oh no.
Watch the vegan getting rewarded.
Oh no!
Oh, that combo is hard on Johnny. Nice.
So yeah, Johnny trying to combo his own janky hurtbox is also a pretty funny idea.
It's mostly the throw combo. It's not, the rest of it isn't easy, but you can actually do it.
Nice
double bear taking the corner.
Ooh, wow, almost went for the Sato.
Oh, TMN.
Nice.
Training mode network, my favorite super.
It really is the best super. Well, we got Peter in the chat coaching double bear. Peter's about
Peter
to go to another Johnny in TMN and from North Carolina and tell them how to do combos.
Really funny if we gave Peter the commentary role and brought him in just for this match.
Oh.
nice.
Okay.
Alright, so it looks pretty good for Vegan. I want to see how Double Bear adjusts in this mirror. Oh my god, Vegan, what in the world?
I have no idea what Vegan is doing.
Vegan, like, synchronizing with the Cliff player in his heart right now with that gold burst.
I mean, once Johnny gets enough meter, he can do a Cliff combo. Oh! That's all I'm seeing.
Nice.
NC would have swept the bracket if NC wasn't so good at the game. Crazy.
Nice. I love to see my boy Vegan prospering.
We love to see Vegan. We love to see a Vegan winning. Vegan, the eat of the eat meat variety, not of the vegan variety. Not that I have anything against vegans.
I mean, obviously we can't have anything against vegans because.
Nice.
Oh no!
No knockdown.
Nice. Beautiful pickup by Double Bear.
This might be. Oh!
Nice.
Oh no! No 6K. Caught I'm gonna press 5H. The standing heavy flash.
A standing heavy splash. What the fuck are you saying?
That was a bit of Daffy Duck impression than I could do.
I ate it here. You know what? You know what? I'm gonna get another glass of water. I already got one. I'm gonna get another one.
My dad who disappears to get a glass of water and never comes back.
I know. That's pretty much how I treat.
Good
all
parent people. Alert. Good parent alert.
Where's the How, where do we know what stream or matches are being streamed?
Yeah, let me send you the brand.
Alright.
It's in TOJ.
Let's see.
Now nice count it 2D, here we go.
Now in the
so every main player I've talked to.
In the tournament, Jacob won. Espada came in second place. So.
Yeah, so every main player I've talked to is not a big fan of this matchup. And a lot of it is just, you're not going to believe this, but what? But Kai has really good tools for dealing with a lot of what Mei is doing.
Wow, I could never have gotten.
But a lot of what Mei is, right, and I mentioned it earlier, is that she really wants you to mess up anti-airing her. Because she's going to try to, like, approach him through the air or surprise you on the ground.
And Kai has great anti-airs and good ground buttons.
Yeah, like, a lot of Kai's good anti-airs against Mei also happen to check things that she's going to do to try to beat those. And so it naturally becomes, like, this question of, it's not that Mei can't devastate this character when she gets in, but her getting in is really tough against Kai's just amazing anti-airs and great neutral presence.
Oh, that could have been death.
And Kai's offense is pretty good against Mei, too.
Kai's offense in general is like pretty good. But against Mei in particular, who's like kind of squishy and has small barre, it's great.
Yeah, and his defensive options are also great against her Oki. So it's like... Yeah, it just really shakes out good for Kai. He gets to control a lot of the screen. FB Star is also just incredible.
Yeah.
In this matchup. Like, being able to just put down like a permanent Mei can't jump here marker on the screen.
Yes. Because a lot of characters can put up like a temporary one. But being able to set one down that is like asynchronous and static, that's really strong.
Mm-hmm.
What a jumping kick.
Nice.
That combo? Ooh.
That's impossible. Oh, so close.
Spada's gonna do a lot of legwork here to run this back. Oh, that was a great 5-H! Oh no!
No combo.
It's like the Mega Mind image. No combo?
Nice.
Oh
my god, the mix-ups.
Why did JS hit that way?
Because he crossed up for a minute, but then just like...
Yeah, he like drifted back over to the right side.
Yeah, due to the JB pushback, so yeah.
Oh, 6H, 6K! It's a Gatling, that's a valid Gatling. As my local state librarian once said. Uh-oh.
As Spada wants blood.
Uh-oh. I came! Oh, come on! What? You don't have to be Kadako. I'm not gonna judge you. Take the money out of this man's pocket.
Yeah, no, and the thing is, you have to be bursted. But why not take the bursted route of Lyakai?
Listen, IKs are even... Oh my god. He did poop and it went under the CSE. Yep, that's... Yeah, you better slash back in, Jacob! Womp womp! Oh.
Ah! Off the back dash. Nice.
Nice.
FD just wants to get out. That was really good. That jump out.
You and Jacob, that was nice air throw, too.
Oh, that works on me. You can just leave it at that.
Whoa! Don't put your hand in the blender! Never do it. It's like those clips of Billy Kane sticking his cane into Ryo's, like, fists.
What the fuck are you- what?
You mean the Zanretsuken hitting Billy Kane, like, for free? Yeah, it's exactly like- Ah, what do you do there? You can't even- Ah!
Xvado overextended.
Yep.
And gets punished.
This is a tough situation, right? Because it's like, mm-hmm. The minute he 3K'd under that, it was like, oh no.
It was game over.
Yeah, because he's got to stand up an FD,
mm-hmm.
And that's going to vacuum all of his meter. Why is Thanks Dev a 1-point redeem? That's amazing.
So you can say thank you. I don't want to charge y'all too much for saying thanks.
I have 5,800 points. I'm using all of them.
Please don't do that.
Okay, Espada. This is my new project. We're grinding that. I'm gonna take you into a VC one night, and we're gonna grind this on pet. I've seen this come up like a couple times. You have to sacrifice honor. For Valve, for blood, or whatever. But when I do it, I'm evil. Yeah. Well, Spada, it's time to make it like the Rocky training montage. Well, we got Luke versus Vegan.
I was watching a Johnny versus Izzy this morning, too. Very interesting.
Yeah, this matchup very much shakes down to, like, please don't get hit, Dizzy. Like, quite literally, if Johnny touches this character, it might be over. But that's the operative word, is if Johnny gets his hand.
If. Because it looks like Dizzy has a really good time keeping him off of the fish as well.
She can. If she gets summon out, Johnny does have to work. But if Johnny controls, like, the mid-range presence really well, he can make it more difficult. A lot of Johnny players don't like this matchup, but realistically, Johnny's ability to kill this character is not to be understated.
I imagine it's say if Johnny plays perfectly, it's really good, but if not, it falls apart really fast.
Yeah, it can be really tough. Oh, that's a big 6K. No combo though, oh! Oh, nice. Luke got a little greedy! Oh, it baits the burst very deliberately. That is in range.
And the cross up.
Nice coin!
More coin and seal, let's go.
Oh, God. Oh, God, that's a low! That's a low! I have to remember that's a low! Alright, here we go. This is the pressure zone that Johnny wants to be in. With Dizzy with no fish, Johnny's buttons are gonna command this space. Oh,
fish is out.
Okay, this is it.
Ooh, safe pressure. Ooh! But drops the combo.
Oh no! Vegan was doing really good. She just gave up really key moments in that corner control. Mm.
Small moments like that can really change up a match.
Yup. Also, we did TMN on Wake Up, which you just never against a fish nice. Setup. You gotta be... That was a great throw. Oh, Inkasu! Oh! Also, he's really got to get acquainted with, like, meeting out of Dizzy's throw range. Because mm-hmm. that caught him quite a bit.
Yeah, Dizzy's got a really good throw, too.
Yeah, her throw range is, like, above average by, like, 4 or 5 pixels, which doesn't sound like a lot, but it shakes out to quite a bit. It means you just have to make sure you're paying attention to where you're spacing your meaties.
Vegan trying to catch the jump out, but drops a little bit.
Nice blocks! All right, we're out. Nice. We're not out. We're domi bursting. But no punish! Air throw! Oh dear. Oh gosh. Oh golly gee.
Oh! Nice throw. Oh my god.
Oh, Inkasu! Eyes of blah! Oh. Oh. Vegan really just needs one more hit. Vegan can convert into Jackhound at this point. Oh, the wheel didn't kill! Oh, Vegan!
Too much aggression.
Yeah, he just ran straight into it. Really gotta pare it down. Oh! He dropped, but he's still at level 2. This is one of those situations where you can still cook.
The thing as well is with the... Them having so much pressure, she keeps backdashing. She will slowly run out of tension, and that's a very big thing to happen.
Nice throw!
Nice throw. Yeah.
And the Inkasu! Yeah, he had the burst there. He had to. Okay, throw. Fish set up. Begin expecting a cross up. You got a meaty! You must meaty. Yeah. Wait, what? Is this first to 3?
Vegan, that was 2. Vegan, that was 2.
Wow. Oh, thank you, Fox, for the raid.
Thanks for the raid. If you're new to TMN, we are a beginner and intermediate focused fighting game community. We run tournaments for nearly every game, and we're running a Uniclear one. I know Fox is big on Uniclear. We're running a Uniclear one next Tuesday. Let me get the link.
I'm excited for Uni 2. Can they make Gordo top tier? That's my mission statement for them. I'm gonna
like Gordo is always top tier first version, so probably.
Yeah, no, I'm basically, if they don't make Gordo top 3, I'm putting a pipe bomb somewhere. They need to do it. It's important to me. Just me. Nobody else.
So we got our top 8 figured out up in Winners Finals. We got first and second seed. Woo woo! I told you. I posted that. They don't know I'm so good at seeding. And then down in Losers, Pato took it over Double Bear to make top 8. Circuit took it over Tanzip to make top 8. Winner gets Espada. Megs took it over TJ. Tragic. Sorry, Megs. And Soul Chart took it over Mikey. And winner gets Vegan. Okay, but before then, let's watch the highlight reel from the last 2 weeks. Now, this is not just plus R footage. This is all of our tournaments, but I hope y'all enjoy. I made it myself. I don't have to. I'm off this one. Well, I hope y'all enjoyed that. We're back at T5, by the way.
I'm here.
Sometimes I chart said that clip of me in the highlight reel is like the only combo I finished last bracket. It was cool though. Okay, so let's get Pata versus Circuit Surgeon. So this will be Abba versus what's his name?
Robokai.
Uh-oh.
I don't think I've ever seen a Robokai versus Ape before, so this is new to me.
Oh, there's a reason. Most Robokai players really do not like this matchup. It really boils down to, like, Abba's Hurtbox being really funky for Robo.
Mm-hmm.
Like, things like 2K2S just do not work a lot. It's which is really bad, because that's, like, the most important Gatling he has. Robo's starting in a really bad position. Defensively speaking, he's like okay versus Abu, but not incredible. And
let's see what Circus Sturgeon's at right now, because he went to losers round one.
Yeah, the big overbearing problem, right, is just that when have you seen Robo get like a knockdown on anything?
Nice, yeah. Throw.
Very character cool. Is a reset machine.
Nice reversal.
I don't have words for that. Oh! Well, that could have been really bad.
He did get the health lead pretty early on, so that was super helpful for him at this point. Oh, got caught once. Might one. Yeah, getting the damage out early against Abba is super important. You really don't want to get
any more. The big trouble beyond the not consistent knockdowns is Robo closing out rounds in general against this character. Robo kind of has a character that has a really easy time building a lot of damage, but once you get to the guts threshold, it can get kind of tricky. And like his guts crush setups are almost always front loaded into like punching super or overclock explosion. What a DP!
Nice reversal, pulling back the round.
There we go. Also, Robo starts in a much worse position than Abba does. Robo with no meter is, oh. Nice DP!
Being given the knockdown.
Oh no.
Abba's really slow wake up time messing with the Roki.
Yeah, although it does end up benefiting most characters. It's just like something you have to remember. But getting more advantage on your knockdowns is never bad. Nice! Like there we go, great awareness. Robo dash and you get all that meter and maybe get a knockdown here.
The damage is going out.
And that's a guaranteed, yep.
He's almost out of meter. Yep.
Yeah, you gotta hold that. Oh no! Whoa!
Nice hit.
Yep, Robo dash is invincible. That's clean. Very good.
Another thing I find with Abas, especially when they're getting close to rounds like that, they're willing to spin the meter for that dash, and that dash is full invul. You cannot hit
it. Yeah, you cannot punish it. Like, it's straight up, you have to bait what they're doing after it.
Mm-hmm.
And usually it's going to be either throw, so they're going to whiff an H normal, or a slash button or whatever, or they're going to be trying to do key grab. Nice 6P.
Gave too much space.
It's gonna be tough. This is a tough situation. It's the meter situation right now. Uh-oh. Accidentally uninstalls. This is, Oh, this is great. Yeah, take that
really
meter.
Good for Robo.
Oh, no! Oh, but...
got the throw after missing the throw.
2+. Oh, yep.
Right, Abe's back in. Let's see what Abe can do.
Yeah, hits the Rekka loops. Oh no!
Baited your reversal.
Right, but still has a lot of meter to work with here. Oh yeah, that's out of DP range anyways. But level 3 missiles!
Anzai.
Oh!
Oh!
Ah yeah! Tough situation. Whoa.
Abe is a very volatile character. You're either winning super hard or you're kind of getting pushed into the corner.
Yeah, this is the position you want to be in as Robo here. Try and get her to blood pack. Oh no! Got a burst. Oh! That's actually a good trade.
Nice.
That's
that
a really, really good trade. Oh no! Danzai is throwing ball. Oh. Yeah, Robo Kai would, in theory, have really, really applicably good counterplay to Danzai as an armored move if it was not thrown.
Mm-hmm.
That is a big problem.
Nice counter.
Yeah. He's got a zone. Build up as much damage as possible. Oh no! Oh, burst! I think it was a panic burst.
Nice.
That missile's coming back.
Throw the throw.
Yeah, okay.
That was a win-win even if it didn't go through.
Yeah, no, it was good. It covered him. That's all he needed at that moment.
Early key grab. Ooh. Oh, the throw right after. throws are super important for this matchup. You really want to get that bar as low as possible.
The blood yeah, as throw. Robo, what if your only stable knockdowns outside of Robo Dash or like a pony is throwing at her, which...
Mm-hmm.
Oh no, I think that's death. Yep.
Yeah. Abe is a volatile character. Your stuff like that can just happen on the fly. It happens.
Good, avoids the key grab. Robo Dash 5H, that frame cap has been putting in a nice lot of work this entire set for... Oh, yes!
Overheated.
It came back. Yes, you can't burst that! Alright. Sturgeon sacrificing their own burst.
Nice reverse.
Oh, orbs are still there, but the invincibility on that DP super avoids it. Oh no, 5k 5d not working because they're just mashing install super as they should. You got the meter.
5d is such a good anti air for Ava to upper body vulnerability and pass.
Oh!
FS team's thrown.
Oh, the drop of the key grab! Oh no, but missiles again!
Over blocks. These missiles are really coming in clutch. Super good at keeping them back when needed.
Nice command grab. Yes, the armor breaking on the DP. That's Suka. No!
Overheated. Oh, he does the reversal again.
What's your punish? Yes, multi-hit. Yes, gets the burst too! Alright, if Sturgeon can win this situation out, they'll be in a good position! Oh no! The overheat! Made that more confirmable!
One good hit can just win the game, even if he blood packs.
Yes! Yep. Drops the Oki! This is what Sturgeon wants. Look at this situation. It's ideal. Jump by Beads wants to land something, get something started here. Good throw!
Nice
good awareness. Meaty low. Oh.
5Ds are just not working this game.
Yeah. Not proving to be a very great strategy. Yay. Yeah, they're just blocking. Great backdash! That was great! Meaty Robo Dash. FRC!
Danzai coming
in. Oh, the 2H just barely avoids the cage! Oh my god. Ah, the 6P! Alright, but they're gonna have to exit.
Overheat.
Ah, the overheat, no!
Ah! He hit it.
TK
and
DP!
The TK. Is this the comeback?
Not enough damage, though! Have so much health! Gotta block! Messes
nice
up the unblockable input, that's it! Oh my god.
Those are some really good throws on Surge Circuits, and that's for sure.
Yeah. That was a really tough... Yeah, when you see, like, a misinput, because, like, you know that was it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Great, yeah, well played,
Surge
though.
Info for not giving up right away. Soul versus Kai.
Alright, yeah, this matchup we get to see again. I'm interested in seeing from the perspective of Giant versus Meg here. Oh, wake up DP! Oh, but Meaty 2P not gonna work. Whoa, that was a Gunflame Fate. Interesting application. Nice FRC, but good air dash out. Ooh, Stun Dipper counter hit. What in the world is that? These are some really interesting, Oh no. No punish.
Oh, got the ground Viper though. Drop the combo. Nice back off.
Yep. Oh, that's a big counter hit. Oh!
The throw, nice.
Oh, the throw. My turn. Gets over the Gunflame and gets the punish. Save jumps! What in the f- what?
Oh. Now the throw. FRC throw. Not a lot of damage, because throws have a lot of proration. But might have been worth it just to keep the health in.
Hold on to the meter, yeah. That's Kai. But... Oh...
Nice escape.
That's a punish! It's not a punish.
Oh. Is this it?
Nice! Clean from Megs! Run it back! Nice wild throw! Ooh, doesn't bait the burst though. Jumps!
Nice jump.
Alright, I think Megs is just controlling the pace really good. Oh, look! Okay, I don't know if that was supposed to be like beating throw, but it was a little risky.
Ooh.
Air CSE, yep. Air CSE again!
Keeping up the pressure.
I can't
nice Tyrant wave for an escape.
What the fuck was that? I'm sorry. Excuse my language. What in the world was that pickup? That didn't
reversal
look like it should have hit. What was that? What in the unholy Virgin Mary did I just look at?
The nicest pickup you've seen.
You're right. You know what? I can't. That's like the ugliest 5k in a combo I've ever seen.
If it works, it works.
Yeah, he was like, I could have just done RC Sidewinder, but Shari was like, no, hold on. I've got an idea.
S style on him sometimes, you know?
Yeah, I felt the burst coming. Oh no! Let's jump out! Oh, unfortunately. Stop doing it! He's like trying to recreate the magic.
The double reversal.
You know why that JS came out too? He was doing 214S to get the javelin. Mm. Oh, lightning orb! Oh! No legs, McGee! What?
Just throw punish.
Buttons are happening. Oh, what
nice
a 5K! The late frame!
Oh.
What?
The tree.
It's like this looks no- huh? What is happening? I'm sorry, I was gonna say it looks normal for 2 seconds and then turns into like a nightmare, but it just keeps going.
This match feels like an actual anime fight, to be honest. It's so all over.
Like they're at first there's like some footsies happening, and then like they just start moving around and doing specials. Mostly because they're trying to hit each other out of movement. But it's just like creating those weird situations. What a DP!
Nice.
That's clean. That's really well played to both players.
Oh but yeah, 100%.
Also, oh my god, that got really hectic.
Those are the most fun fights though.
Oh yeah. That's when you're like deep in the spaghetti.
Oh yeah.
And like at that point, that's like the lasagna fight.
Nah.
Very, very clean.
Okay, up next we're gonna have a Espada versus Circuit Surgeon, and Chart will move on to fight Vegan.
Alright, Circuit Sturgeon versus Espada. Robo May? Interesting.
Circuit took this last time. Like, very close set, but took.
I'm interested in Luke Jacob, too, because those are both the people that can graduate, right?
Yeah.
In Winner's Finals, that's so funny. Mm-hmm. Alright, here we go. Look at the round start. Immediately puts a mat out, wants to get some meter. Yeah, that's really what you want to do. If Mei is not going to come to you, you might as well take advantage and build some meter.
Imagine Robokai also has some good antsiers and pressure. Oh.
Robokai doesn't quite have the same type of antsiers as Kai. But he does have one really nice thing, and that's that he's almost never going to get stunned in this matchup. Like, unless he makes many mistakes, or at least a couple of very big errors, he will take a lot of damage.
Missed the grab.
What an
air throw!
That was an
another throw.
Yeah, goes low.
Lagging pressure.
Five oh, it does!
Finally went through. Whiffs.
Wait, was that IK activation? Oh, good 2S.
Scream.
If you're gonna trade with Dolphin, scream. You might as well. Oh, there's
yeah, it's better to
trade.
Take that than a full combo.
Well, nice probably supposed to be a TK DP, that JH, though. Delay, wake
nice
up!
Delay.
Yeah, I'm liking the zoning right now. Yeah! Big damage.
Nice. Yep.
Shulin, using the missiles.
Head meter
crucially
first.
Crucially too? Up burst, yeah.
Nice. trading.
He's mashing that on wake up, probably because he's going for throw, and Mace 5k is just iframing it. But the end result is that he's getting a 6h that is counter hitting and trading.
Oh, that missile
rocket turnaround.
All these big pony counter hits could be so much more. Yep. Spada's like, get me out of here. Oh, the overhead lands.
Oh.
Oh no, there it is. The classic. My 6P. This looks like Sturgeon's having a really hard time maintaining momentum. The spot is doing a really good job of just kind of like breaking the zoning he's trying to do as well. And the end result is just like...
massive damage.
Nice block.
Nice.
That's gonna do a bit of damage.
A lot of damage. Not a hard knockdown.
Oh!
Can this be the comeback?
Big meter. Nice pony. Midi low. One more guess.
Oh,
next hit is gonna decide it. Oh, the missile connects.
Missiles caught him on the startup. 6P.
Nice, yeah, these 6Ps. Alright, Sturgeon changing how they're controlling the pace a little. And now a spot is having a hard time getting in again. So let's see what happens. Air missiles.
A lot of damage.
Oh, yeah.
They add up over time. Big damage.
Oh, but all that momentum. Slipping away! It's slipping away! Oh, but! Okay. Gets the burst out of him. Oh! There's no FRC on that. That could have been a big punish. That's gonna chip you out!
Yeah, no meter. Meter's a super valuable resource for Robokai. He can't build it as well as other characters can unless he has that mad out.
Yeah! Oh, the heat loops! Yeah! There we go. Get them all the way to the corner. Oh, wins for the command grab. Once more meter. But just, oh no! The backdash is so fast, it ended up getting snagged. Mm. Oh god, that was scary.
Crossed up.
Oh, below!
Oh.
Nice pickup. Oh no, Rubble's too heavy! Oh!
Bill gets the 5D combo.
Yeah, I think that trade messed up Espada's homing jump. He blocks the overhead!
Gets the grab. And can he turn this around and go to the next round?
Oh yeah, he's bursting. He's not. Oh, the 3K! Yeah, that's smart.
On the toes.
Perfect choice. All you need is one more hit, right? So you're just gonna go under missiles.
Spada will go on to fight the winner of the next match, which is gonna be Chart versus Vegan. Okay, Johnny versus Soul.
Ah, yes. This is a classic matchup.
Hopefully Chart can finish some combos today, because Vegan took this rather convincingly last time. Not last tournament, but the last time they fought, because Chart was not on a good combo day.
No, it happens. Sometimes you just have days where you just can't do it.
Yeah, it happens. Let's see, though. So this matchup is really interesting. Johnny has a lot of little things that don't really... How do I put it? Soul has a lot of things that irritate the hell out of Johnny. But Johnny also has things that irritate Soul. Namely, that he falls out of the DP ender if it's like done as a starter. It's like if you do wake up DP, you can't get Johnny knocked down in rem pressure. And when Johnny's at the poking range and Soul can't, you know, have the breathing room to do run-up 2D and interrupts with low profile, Johnny can really smother this character. But Soul can also really disrupt Johnny's pace with, like, low profile and stuff like 2D and great anti-airs and, of course, Volcanic Viper, even without the knockdown. Oh, he hit a button!
Nice.
If he had just kept blocking, that would have been a great starter.
A lot of TMNs come from Vegan the Smith. Oh, just one hit. Yeah.
Nice throw. Take the damage, yep. Oh, TMN! Every time I say that, Dub smiles. What a funny little guy. Oh!
Just out of range.
Nice pick up on that counter hit coin! Oh, and gets the burst!
And
oh,
the
no!
Drops the combo.
My goodness.
Hero burst. Like he's
This might be huge.
And this goes back to what we were saying earlier about saving those bursts. Like they can really help.
Oh no! Oh!
Oh!
Oh! Oh!
Oh! Reversal.
HPP. Whoa! Nice throw. All right. Oh, that is nearly a stun.
Is he? No.
That's gonna be a stun.
Nice.
Johnny's combos and like the way Johnny gets stuns in those situations is really tough because they're so high up in the air they have a lot of time to mash. Heaven or hell? Let's rock. Oh, big first bait. Oh, baby. Oh, no, the Sidebinder dropped.
Bursting early isn't the worst thing in the world, because at least you can build it back, but if you die with that, you know, it can be hard.
Yeah. Ooh.
Too early.
Chart does not want to give up this round at all. Oh, yeah.
It worked out. It was stupid, Chart, but it worked.
Sometimes the plays that no one can predict are the best.
If y'all didn't know, Twitter decided Chart and I are married.
And that I'm Chart's parent.
That you're Chart's parent.
Which is really funny, because I got pinged with that when I got home from work today. I'm like, what?
Yeah, I got home from dropping my husband off and getting my COVID shot, and I was like, what the fuck?
Oh, nice 5K. This is big.
Nice.
Nice, and gets the knockdown!
Chart's combos have been on point today.
Oh, he was looking for burst. He was looking for that burst.
Jump heavy slash pulling in some work again.
Oh!
The dust.
Oh no! He wasn't ready! Entirely realistic that 5D was a misinput, but it worked out. Well, we're 1-1 now. This is it. Vegan fighting for his tournament life. Chart! Running it back.
This'll teach Vegan, I hope, not gonna lie, Vegan was saying earlier, only two people in this bracket scare me, and I need Vegan to stop saying that, because you need to treat everyone like they're a threat.
Oh,
because
yeah,
they can be.
Tourneyers also play a role in where, like, you might not be playing, like, the best when they're in the tournament either.
All right, down a burst.
Round for Chart to win. Vegan moves on to fight Espada if he wins this one.
Oh, big one under. Good pickup.
Oh, into the wild throw. Another wild throw. Nice.
You are getting thrown!
Running it back. Another one? One more? Nah. We're gonna cut it short. Gets the OTG!
Oh.
Doesn't fly over the TMN.
Antier.
Don't you fucking dare DP, bro! Nice!
Oh, okay, here we go.
Final, baby!
Last round!
Very even players right here.
Oh my god, the coin nullified the gunflame!
Vegan's first.
This is immediately kind of dangerous territory for Vegan right now. Good throw!
Oh.
Nice tech chase, but...
Ow.
Oh, baby.
Big damage.
Yeah, can't really see the other side rounders coming out there. The spacing just wasn't it. Nice IB on the second hit!
Nice.
Goldbergs!
Air throw!
Can you get the comeback going?
Okay, we can do a lot of cash out with this. This is deteriorated. No! Oh!
That misinput saved his life! He wanted Fafnir!
No burst.
No punish! Where's Grand Viper? Yes,
yes, Let's go, Chart! Here we go! Nice shit, Chart.
Incredibly close matches. That they were very well
not
timed.
Never count not out British Batman.
Never count out Chart. So true. Yeah, let's get Jacob and Lincoln here.
I was really happy he gets to look like the wise sensei. What did I tell you, Vegan?
My hands hurt from how loud I clapped when Vegan got that. When the Chart got that. Okay, up next, we're gonna have Luke versus Jacob for Winners Finals. This will be a first of three.
Alright, here we go. This matchup is really funny. I've never really particularly seen it talked about a lot, but I do know Kai does alright. As far as I remember. He's got great neutral control buttons, and naturally, his Oki is pretty solid against Dizzy too, and he gets to get pretty good damage. Yeah, Dizzy's so paper thin, right? I don't think it's quite as much as it is in Kai Milia, right?
Nice.
Because like in Kai Milia, Milia's guard bar is getting like cranked to high hill, and then Kai is hitting her. Whereas Dizzy has average guard bar builds-ish, if I'm not mistaken. It's about normal for the cast. Nice!
Another thing I can imagine is that Kai doesn't really have to be in Dizzy's throw range either. With stun and choke.
He can do a lot of like throw safe pressure. Nice air throw! Jump high B too
awesome
to cancel. Woo, that movement was sick from Jacob! Oh my god! Oh, the air throw though! That's huge. Missed. That's not a punish. Yeah, I like what Jacob's doing here. He wants to get in and get started.
As long as Dizzy can't get that fish out, she really
not want.
That.
Yeah, he doesn't want. Oh, that was great. Ah, oh! Ah, oh, JH. Oh, oh. Whoa, interesting pick throw. I don't really want to be doing that until you know Dizzy's coming back in.
Yeah.
Yep.
Dizzy entered her win con and zoned him out.
Yeah, tricky situation. Nice JP, but oh, I think that was a good JP in anticipation of it getting blocked, maybe? But definitely hampered the conversion potential. Nice 5P! Here we go! My head's in my hands right now. My head is just, like, squarely in my hands. Gets out, but... Yeah.
Ate the reversal.
That's DP safe, you cannot do anything about tet like that, no? That was Luke 2, yes. Yeah. Yeah. Nice! Okay, Jacob's making some big adaptations here. His movement's getting a little cleaner. I think he's getting a better feel for where Luke wants to press. That was a really good falling JP there to cover that. I was wondering if he was gonna land and get thrown. Oh, the bubble? Yeah, has to burst. Kills fish, yeah, smart.
Yep, now he's getting this pressure going. Make sure that fish does not
staying
come
in. He just wants to aggress. With respect to Dizzy's second air dash. Lightning Orb, she's trying to catch something here. What an air throw!
Nice air throw.
Gets the knockdown too. The jump IB, but not enough. Another air throw. Oh, FB Green Saber gets blocked, but it's so hard to punish. Oh! Oh, I like threw my head back. I threw my head back, Jacob! Oh, the stun dipper, that's critical. And gets the burst! Alright, this is a really good situation for Jacob. He's spending all of his meter!
All that meter gone.
This time, not 3-H-ing in throw range. Oh, that's gonna be good damage.
Good damage, yeah.
And Okazemi. That had to have been stunned. That had to have been stunned. He wanted a stunned, Captain.
Yep. Now he's got to try to fight his way back in.
Yeah, this is. The stunned goes
nice
under.
Stunned.
Oh my god. It slid right under the FB needles. Oh, nice ice spike! Catching the movement preemptively. Oh, the JK! Oh, that 6P didn't quite do it. Nice blocks. Great defense. Great, that was really good. That was really greedy.
Blocking a lot of greed setters. Not working out at the moment.
Oh my god. Like, in this pressure, just wants to stay and jump IB, but no! Nothing to say. Nice stunnage, snipes the fish out. That's what you want. You don't want fish out there. Yeah, okay, I think he recognized that wouldn't combo. Stunnage, he saw it get IB'd. Oh no! Oh my god! Is he dead? Oh my god, he's alive! One pixel! I don't know how he's gonna run this back. It's possible. It's just gonna be really difficult. He kills a fish!
Hey, well, Luke's sitting pretty in winner's finals. Now we're gonna get Espada versus Chart. Now, Chart has played this a lot, because, like, these two have been entering our tournaments forever, and Chart and Espada have played each other a lot. I don't think Chart's ever taken it. I'm gonna be honest. I can't think of a time Chart has taken it. So... And Espada, you know, running off the loser, the third place curse, I did tell Espada if he wins one, he graduates, just because he's placed second so fucking much. We'll see what happens.
Oh, it would be quite the story if Espada could do it this way.
When did you beat Espada? Like, in tournament?
I want Espada to win this one. Just because I want the Espada narrative.
I want the Espada movie. He always edits a video when he graduates a bracket. Oh, nice throw!
You know the Espada video is gonna be like this beautiful moving like piece. It has to really summarize that feeling of 2 years.
I'm gonna have to get him to send you his for when he graduated Only Mids. Have you seen that?
We have specific vids about it, or
he edited a video about his journey through getting better at the game and being able to graduate through the Only Mids eye of that one tournament series. Their Exart. Graduating Only Mids is an Exart beginner intermediate tournament.
I do like Soul's patience here.
Yeah, Chart is being really patient, not getting clipped by these a spot is really good at just like scrambling better than you, and Chart's just not engaging with it, which I think is really good.
Mm-hmm. Big damage from Soul. Gets clipped in the air.
So I think the coolest narrative possible beyond Espada would kind of be Chart.
If Chart wins this, I will literally pop off harder than I've ever popped off in my entire fucking life.
The loudest I've screamed for a British person that isn't like a fucking 80s
my
rock band.
My little baby boy! I love Chart so much! Okay?
Exactly! No, like I said, it'll be like
and,
the
and
most
And he has been grinding this tournament for, I think, a second longer than Espada. He's been entering this tournament since it first started, like second tournament.
Like, genuinely, I can't think of who else I'd pop off for beyond like an 80s British rock band more. It's from the United Kingdom, then Chart.
Nice,
oh,
what a heavy slash.
Yeah, I cannot think of anyone in those brackets that deserves it more than Chart, but we'll see.
Heaven or hell, duel, next rock, Tucker!
What was that?
Couldn't get the bandit breeder.
It was a plan.
I like that preemptive up dolphin to interrupt anything Sharp was going to try to do above him. Espada seems really scared to put out buttons in neutral. Like, I know he's pressing a lot of buttons. We usually see him press a lot more buttons. Oh, try to throw. Yeah, just DP. Soul JP, everybody!
It's your wild. Throw.
It's the same in Dexar! Nothing fucking changes!
Oh, the flat circle! Oh, nice 6H to. Yeah, just.
Nice.
Just get a little bit of stun racked up. Oh, you get hit by that. Yeah, Chart is the goat, Timmy's. It's so true. Chart, we were just saying, Timmy's, like, there's anyone who deserves it in this bracket.
Holy shit, Timmy's is alive?
Yeah, Timmy's is in the chat right now.
I haven't seen Timmy's in forever. What the fuck? Where have you been?
Oh, nice! Oh,
the awareness! He was aware! He was so ready for that! He blocked low! He was ready!
Oh
my god, Chart!
Chart's really putting in some work this game.
Chart's playing so well!
I'm a very big appreciator of patient play. I am biased though, because I play bridge.
It's the Chart moment.
Hey Abyss, how are you today? Let me get Espada. Now, Jacob was the player that Chart lost to in Winners.
Yeah.
But Chart was not playing this well in Winners. So
he's all warmed up now.
Yeah. So let's
got the gears going.
We're waiting on Jacob. Oofy Jacob, get in here. Get in the robot. Jacob.
Jacob.
The sad part is we can't run anything else. How y'all doing tonight? Yeah, Chart, you're doing. I don't know if you had. Did you have to stream on Chart at the beginning of that set? Because we were singing your praise.
You're doing very good. Keep it up, British Batman. What, you gotta find your British Robin. Well, Vegan, what did we tell you? Good mental, but be ready for everybody.
He is here now.
Anime start. I love
it. Iconics. That's Jacob, the big anti-air. I feel like Jacob has played this matchup a little bit more.
Yeah.
Oh, that JH talk was really clean to get over that projectile. Pulling his body upwards. What the frig happened there? Nice kick throw! Oh, he was looking for this. Oh, you gotta be careful. Oh look, you don't want to fight them, they'll send me in instead. No, I'm kidding.
Jacob being very patient.
Ooh!
Oh, nice!
Nice! He's on one pixel right now.
He can do it, he can do it! Don't get DP'd!
Oh!
Oh! Oh no!
Oh, turn!
Thrown, he was committed to down back. He had three dots!
Good block. Yeah, don't even bother trying to wake up.
No, you're gonna get injured.
Oh,
yeah.
No, you
Jacob
really gotta
be
careful.
Jacob is fundamentally clean that you're not gonna jump in on him like that. Okay. Dicey P! Got hit out, but it's okay. You show him you'll do it. Okay. Doesn't get anti-air. Nice up there. Nice throw!
No, you!
Reversal throw.
Oh no!
Oh my god! Good combo here?
Brain trap.
And the death loop is too far!
Nice throw.
Oh! That was the right idea, just a little bit mistimed.
Oh no, didn't reach. No, big burst!
There's eight.
Yeah, three H's, beat all that. No.
No, you can't wonder that. You're blocking. No, you gotta be patient. Nice. Oh!
What happened there?
He was expecting burst. He wanted to air throw their burst after they bursted GV.
Okay.
Is my assumption.
Jacob's been showing the willingness to hold burst, especially with the lead.
That was like no damage, holy shit. JH moment. Nice side kick. Nice smash there. Oh no, gets bursted! Oh my god, yeah, we throw those. I don't know if our British hero will be able to make it. Chart mastery match, bro. Holy shit. Chart's like, I wanna go to bed.
Come on, Chart. I believe.
The biggest comeback in history.
Seth to win three. Uh oh. No, hey, you gotta be more patient. I think the patience is running out.
Mm.
Oh, but! Nice whiff punish. Yeah. Oh. Nice!
Throw.
Yeah. Oh, lightning orb.
Jacob is adapting pretty fast to a lot of Chart's options here.
Nice! Oh my god, yeah, we gotta dump all this meter. Huh? Huh? Oh, nice. DPRC the classic! That's okay, here we go.
It's coming, babes. Let him preheat.
Oh, catches him with the timing!
Just out of range.
No, they wanted to throw!
Reed 7 being used to dodge projectile 7 mix. Let's go.
Oh, not in range! That Jacob just mashed them out. Oh, you can't ground Viper under that! That's gonna be it. Oh, no burst! Chat holding on. Yeah. They know. That burst would have been like. Their last. Big. Big! That's a great trade, but no pickup! Gold burst!
Gold burst? Can he use the gold burst?
All this meter. Alright, the cool combo, yet again. Oh my god, what a wake up back there. Riot Stamp! That was so good! I don't know what he pressed! Let's learn! Oh! Out of the corner! Happy Star!
Star keeping him back.
One more hit. Yab. That's a good effort.
Chart, you did so good. Don't 32 people, you got third. That is nothing to first and second seed at that. Nah, you did great.
You placed above your seed, and this is like the biggest TMN beginner bracket ever.
Yeah.
For plus R, and you just got third. So, good work.
Yeah, good shit, Chart. Yo, my favorite song.
Oh, here we go.
Will it be a sweep like it was in Lair's?
Oh, good throw from Jacob. Let's see if Jacob's a little bit more in his element. That was ambitious. At this moment in time, I'm willing to bet Jacob was like, damn, I just wish Kai had air lightning orb. Oh!
Oh, gold burst. They're both even on burst, but Kai does not have the health.
Yeah, Kai's gonna end up with more burst by the start of next round.
Mm.
Oh god, I hit the wrong button. Whoops. That is on me. Quick, fill me in on what's happening, Foxbuck.
Let's see, Dizzy got the air throw, he's got Fish out. Really getting a big health lead here and locking out the Kai. Kai gets a hit, is now applying pressure to him. He gets a nice throw. Trying to keep Dizzy down. This is a nice stun.
Alright, here we go. Nice, yeah, alright, back to neutral. Jacob with a full burst on what an air throw!
FRC into air throw.
Yeah, I guess at least plus frames. You're not gonna jump, you're not gonna move, you're gonna stay right there.
Hard bar tie.
Oh!
Hard bar tie if he just needs one hit to go off.
What an air throw!
Mm. both missed an air thrown, but Kai gets the
first. Oh my god, Jacob! Oh my lord.
A lot of jump punches. Dizzy's now zoning. Nope, Kai's back in.
Yep. Nice, snipes the fish. Couldn't quite clear it. Yep.
Fish doing fish things. EP missed though.
Oh, gets on the wheel, nice.
Nice stopping the fish.
Oh. Oh, these JDs are not working out. These airstreams. What a throw, man.
Oh. Tried catching him on the dash, but Dizzy has two dashes. Death RC saving him.
Whoa. That's a wild cross up. Oh yeah, he had to burst that Stun Dipper. Anytime Stun Dipper gets that awesome counter hit at the beginning. Oh!
Not out yet.
Jacob in a really dicey spot. Gotta get off that bubble! He does, he gets out. Whoa!
A lot of maneuvering around, a lot of attacks in the beginning.
Okay, nice. It's the BCSE? What you want? Take a good Oki. Yeah, Lightning Orb.
Trying to keep that pressure up. Get build that guard bar, because he just needs
one hit. Ooh, yeah, like, even that just did time damage. For what it was.
That's the one thing, if Kai can guard bar up, he does a lot of damage.
Yeah, Kai, if Kai gets your guard bar up, you hurt real bad. Nice, I like that. Yeah, how long you want to block, right?
Look at that. Like, that guard bar allowed the throw to kill. Like, without that extra bonus damage, she might not have gotten it there.
Yep. J2S, though. Oh, I think he wanted to 6P the fish, but didn't quite work. Counter hit. Yeah, bye. Yep.
A lot closer, that's for sure.
Yeah, take some time, Jacob. It's okay. Okay. Says the connection's really bad.
I am noticing the game is saying waiting. But I don't know if that's an indication of Spectator-minator. Or me loving internet routing.
They're both gonna restart the game and see if that helps.
Round three.
Heaven or hell? Duel. One. Let's rock. Nah, it's still bad, damn it. Okay, well. They both seem okay with it, so.
You're kind of seeing it, right?
Yeah. Mm. Unfortunately, Dizzy works a little bit better in this kind of situation.
Oy. Well,
yeah, it's the last game. Sad. Oh, it just got a lot worse though since they restarted the game. That's crazy. Okay.
I almost just typed Donkey Kong in your chat.
Luke's been really blocking a lot of those overhead Creed setters.
Oh!
Ooh.
I was excited. I was like, there goes Dizzy, but... That's just, bye. You hate to see, like, this kind of thing happen.
Yeah, especially between two talented players like this. Where it would be really fun to see them actually play.
Yup. Yeah, I genuinely do think, like, a character like Dizzy is a little unfortunate in this situation. What? That's a funny thing you can do, I guess. I've never seen that. Nice jump IB! Oh!
Nice combo. Try doing stun edge in the air, I assume.
Okay!
Look, the zoning. Yeah.
Okay. Good shit. That means Luke graduates. Congrats,
Let's
Luke.
Go.
Why'd they start playing again? Hello?
Oh, I don't know.
Okay.
Disconnected.
Okay. I told Luke, if he wants to graduate, like, on a proper win, I'll allow him to, but...
Do you want
to
do this chart still awake? I was gonna say graduation
charting.
Bug finals between Chart and Jacob.
Yeah, okay, let me ask her.
Do you what? I mean, do Jacob wants to graduate? You can ask him, actually.
Okay.
Nah, don't.
Nah, that's
stupid. I think Jacob should graduate in the proper win piece.
Yeah, that's stupid. Okay, yeah, that's
let
stupid.
Let the Fiji water,
don't come
man.
Up with stupid shit anymore. Okay, let me... I don't know what Luke's Twitter is. Okay, What the fuck are you burning down a castle? No, I'm raiding someone on Twitch! The fuck? Luke? Okay, let me finish up the, did you see that we have a custom, top 8 chart now? Top 8 thing now? It takes a little bit longer to fill out, but it's, fun. I like it.
Does it have me on it?
No!
Well, I don't care, no, I'm kidding.
Damn, bitch.
Oh, I don't know then. She made this person called Dovingly. He's streaming Basar, it looks like.
Bitch, that's me. Okay, let me give... Okay. Then I'll just shoot someone to raid. If he doesn't know. Okay, let's see. Who we got streaming right now? Help me pick, y'all. Let me look if anyone's streaming Basar. It's us in the quick match, viewer. Let's see. Who's for me right now? I'm gonna raid Ryer. I love that boy. Oh no, Neil! Neil! My bestie, Neil! I'm gonna raid Neil. Okay. Thank you so much for coming, everyone. Sorry about the rough way it ended, but I hope we, he'll have a, Luke will have another chance to graduate the proper way. If he doesn't graduate then I don't know, I'm kicking him out, but whatever. Anyway, have a good evening, everyone. See you on the flip side. Thank you, Fox and T5. You did a great job.
You're welcome.
Fox, you did a great job.
Thank you.
Yeah.
For your first time commentating, you sounded much less, like, nervous than a lot of people do and had a lot more insightful things to say. So, have a good night, everyone.
Just fine. All right. Thank you.